What's going on, Lead Gen Bees? Matty Ice here, Leads for Locals. Today, we're going to have some fun creating some awesome, awesome Facebook ad creatives inside of Canva. I want to show you step by step how to create just awesome ad creatives that stand out really good in the newsfeed. They get really good engagement. How do I know this? Because I've actually run these types of campaigns. I've actually used the exact ad creatives that I'm going to show you. I'm going to start by just showing you some examples here. And then I want to show you step by step how to create them inside of Canva using templates. That's one of the things I absolutely love about Canva is all the templates that they provide and how easy it is to customize it for your offer, your business, your messaging, etc. All right. So my only ask, as usual, guys, if you find the video helpful, please do hit that like button. Really does help. Make sure you check out all the links in the description. I'm going to have additional training and resources just to help you take your marketing to the next level. I have a free digital marketing masterclass that I just put together. I'll have that in the description as well, because you want to make sure that you have the whole package here. All right. So being able to put together really good ad creatives, that is important, but that's just one part of the marketing equation. You've got to make sure that your offer is good. You got the right lead magnets, your funnel's in place, you got the follow-up systems in place, etc. So I talk a lot about that in that masterclass. So make sure you check it out. But with that said, without further ado, let's go ahead. I'm going to share my screen here. Hop into Canva. And guys, if you want to support the channel, assuming you find this video helpful, if you do want to do that, I would really appreciate your support. I will have an affiliate link for Canva in the description. It's only 13, 14 bucks a month. And I use Canva for so many different things, pretty much anything that has to do with graphic design, ad creatives, video. Like I create a lot of videos. You can do presentations. I've done those inside of Canva as well. There's so much awesome stuff you can create and utilize inside of Canva. So, but if you want to support the channel, my link will be in the description. I appreciate it. So first thing that I want to do is go through some specific examples here of different types of ad creatives that I have had really good success with and the different types of campaigns that I've run. And I've used just like single image ads. I've done carousel ads. I've done static video ads. I've done regular video ads. Recently, I started using post style ads. I'll show you that here in a second. And they work really, really good. And having a combination of these different ad creatives inside of your campaign can actually help improve your results because you're giving Facebook some variety to work with. And it can split. It's basically split testing the different ad creatives to see which one is going to be best. So if you're doing $20, $25 per day for your ad campaign, for example, I usually like to have at least two, usually three ads within that ad set, and I'll have a single image or a post style image. I'll have a static video, and then I'll have a carousel ad, and I'll let Facebook figure out which one works best. So it's really good for creating some variety here. What I want to start with, I want to start with this post style ad. The reason I call it a post style ad is because it looks like a post inside somebody's newsfeed. It doesn't actually look like an ad, does it? Yet it works really good. And you know, some people might say, it doesn't look professional, whatever, it won't work for my industry. Wrong. I have used this specific type of ad creative in like a dozen different industries now, testing it out, and it works really, really good. We get fantastic engagement with these very simple types of ads. And I'll show you how to create it here in a second. So that's the post style ad. This is a static video ad creative that I've used in the past too that I've had good success with. And it's just text on the video, and then it's just got like a cool video background, and you can use any type of video that you want. But I just really like this one. It stands out in the newsfeed. It looks really cool. And also the good thing about running video ads is that you can create custom audiences based on how much of the video, like what percentage of the video that they've watched. So that's an additional benefit. This is another example of a post style ad. I just put like a cool background in it, and you know, adjusted the transparency. Again, I'll show you how to create this in a second. This is the carousel ad that I really like to use. It is awesome. I've had fantastic results with this carousel ad. And basically, what it does is people are able to swipe through the different slides in the carousel ad, so you're able to put a lot more content in one ad creative. And these tend to get really, really good engagement, and you could just tell more of a story here, right? So in this particular case, we're offering like a free ebook for business owners to reduce their annual FICA payroll taxes. So, you know, we capture their attention, and then we go through And again, we're able to say a lot more about the problem, the solution, the offer, et cetera. So we just go through, like people can swipe through these various different slides. And anytime they click one of them, it opens up the lead form and they can, you know, get the free ebook, right? Same thing here. This is more like a content-based style carousel ad. This one I haven't run yet. This is going to be new. But same, very similar concept as the carousel ad that I just showed you, where we're providing a lot of content, a lot of educational value, teaching people things, and it's answering questions, it's generating that curiosity, things like that. And you know, again, we're able to just get a lot of content in one ad creative. I still have to finish it here, but it looks really cool in the newsfeed. So those are the examples that we're going to be creating here. Let's go ahead and head back to the Canva homepage. All right, we're gonna, like, guys, all, like, most of the ads that you just saw were templates, and if they weren't, they were very, very easy to create. So let's start with these post style ads. I want to do this one, and let's do this one. Okay, so let's create these really quick. How do we create these post style ads? Two different variations here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna click on create a design up here at the top right. We're going to do I just do an Instagram post for the size here. So it's a 1080 by 1080 for this. All right. So we're going to open that up. And guys, please make sure you play around with this, play around with different templates. All right. Don't just take what I'm showing you and just do that. I mean, you could obviously start with that because they work really well, but go through some of these different templates. You know, let's type in, you know, put financial, you know, type in success, marketing, whatever industry that you're in, and, you know, play around with these different templates. All right. That's one of the awesome things about Canva. But let's do, so we're going to find background here, and you might have to go into apps or click on the little, I did not mean to do that. That's Loom. But anyways, like if there's like on the sidebar here, if you don't see something specific, sometimes they're like hidden in other elements here, other parts of the sidebar. So just keep that in mind. But what I'm going to do here is click on background, and you're going to go to gradients, see all, and I usually use this one, and this one. Actually, sometimes I'll do the light blue too. All right. But all we're doing here for this particular ad creative is selecting a gradient background. That's literally all we're doing. And then we're going to click on text, add a heading. And what did I put here? Create a free annuity income guide that teaches. All right. So I'm not going to really need to type out everything, but just created and the inspiration for this was like, I see a lot of posts in my newsfeed, like especially from marketers and people in a similar industry where they're talking about something they just created, like a free training, a new testimonial video. Like they just got all these crazy results for somebody, and they do that post, and then they'll ask, who wants to learn how to do this? Who wants a copy of the ebook, the webinar, the masterclass, whatever? And oftentimes you'll see those posts get a lot of engagement. And that's basically what we're recreating here for this ad campaign. So just created a free annuity income guide, teaching the basics about annuities, something like that. All right, we're going to drag this up. Let's add a subheading here. Who wants a copy? Wow, I can't believe I just did that. Who wants a copy? All right, and then to make this pop a little bit more, we could change the colors a little bit. So if you just select the text, all right, come up here to text color. We'll just change up the color a little bit, and we could do the same thing here. Let's say we want to highlight this, the free annuity guide, just make that stand out. We'll do the same color. All right. And then we can select this too. I like the effects here, the outline. It makes this pop really good. If we change the color of the outline to to black, look at that. It makes the text pop really, really good. All right. So let's do that effect here on this one. All right. That's it. You have your post style ad right there, guys. And if you want, sometimes what I like to do also, actually, you know what? I'll show it to you on the on this one where I like to create what looks like a button, and we're not creating the button inside of Canva, but it acts as a button when you run it as a Facebook ad, because whenever somebody clicks your ad image, your ad creative, the lead form pops up, or it sends them to your opt-in page, whatever. All right. So that's how we create this one, guys. Literally all you're going to do at that point is give it a name right here, share, download, download it as a PNG. That's it. That's all you got to do. All right. So that's that. That's this ad. All right. Let's recreate this one. So I'm not going to change the text here, but I am going to show you how to add the button. So who wants a copy? Let's just do, we're going to add one more piece of text here, the subheading, and we're going to type in learn more. And all we're going to do, guys, is go to elements. We're going to go to shapes, grab the square here. And, come on. All right. We're going to drag it, resize it. All right. Make sure it's aligned. Maybe we want to change the color. All right. Let's see. Come on. I want the button. All right. Why is that not changing? Not sure why the button color is not changing. That's got to be some kind of glitch. But usually you can, you select the, it's really weird. You just select the button and you change the color. I don't know why it's, there we go. Oh, yeah. I was doing text color, duh. Yeah, I'm an idiot. Sorry. So you could change the color of the button. And let's go ahead and change this background. So all I did for this one right here, creating this cool little background, I'm going to select this back, the gradient background that we added earlier. I'm just going to delete it. Obviously, you would create a new ad here. So just go back to Canva, Instagram post, 1080 by 1080. All right. Just saving tabs here. So next, what we want to do is actually make this background color solid black. And you'll see why here in a second. We're going to go to photos. All right. We're talking about annuity. So again, I'm going to type in financial here. And I'm just going to find an image that I think looks really cool. Let's do this one. All right. We're going to frame it. Okay. Resize it. All right. We're going to click position to back. That's what we're going to select. And now we want the text to pop more. So what we're going to do is reduce the transparency. Look at that. Boom. That's it. So we now have another, it's a different type of post style ad here. And, maybe this text is a little bit big. All right. Create a little bit more room there. Guys, you have another post style ad. That's it. Name it, download it. You're good to go. Okay. So that's this one. Those are our post style ads. Let's do a static video ad here. For this, I actually do the same. I just do an Instagram post for the size 1080 by 1080. All right, so let's delete this background image here. All right, and now this time, all we're gonna do is video. And actually, what you can do too, is this the same size? Yeah, okay, Instagram post video. We could also type in Facebook video. I think it's the same size. Yeah, it's the same size. But again, when you create new ads like this, when you start from scratch in Canva, and you type in the specific type of creative that you're looking for, like a video, it brings up just different types of templates right off the bat here. All right, so we can scroll through and find different videos and templates that you like. That's how I found this right here. And if you like this one, I think this one was specifically like a breaking, if we type in breaking news. Yeah, here it is. Right. So you got all these like different breaking news types of videos and stuff in the background. So like we could select this here. All right. Let's reduce the transparency again. Hang on a second. Whoops. Did not mean to do that. Let's do undo. All right, we're going to change that to black. There we go. And reduce the transparency just a little bit so our text pops. Now, all this stuff we don't really want, maybe you do. You could totally just customize all that text. But for our purposes, I'm just going to delete all of that, and we're going to add our own stuff here. All right, so let's see. What did I put here? So I put attention, fellow investors. So what we're going to do for that is add a heading, and I'm just going to type in attention, fellow investors. All right. We're going to reduce the size here a little bit. All right. Let's put our effect on for the outline. We're going to make that outline black, and let's change our text color. this guy. All right, we're going to drag that up. All right. Attention, fellow investors, free investors, recession survival guide. All right, so let's put that in. I'm just going to put free investors survival guide. All right, let's change that font color. All right, so we got to select all that. All right, maybe we want to drag this out just a little bit. All right, you can put the effect on if you want, the outline effect. All right, and then we're going to add one more piece of text. So we said we're getting the attention of our target audience. We're letting them know what this ad is about, what we're offering. Here's the lead magnet and a quick statement about what they're going to get. So in this case, they're going to learn how to protect and grow their wealth during the coming recession. That's it. So we would add a subheading here or a regular heading. It doesn't matter. Learn how to do X, Y, Z. Okay, maybe we change this font color to this guy. Yeah, we'll do that one just to change it up a little bit. That would definitely look better with the outline effect. But from there, we just need to add the learn more button. All right, so we're going to add another subheading, learn more, add our square element here. And we're just going to come on. And actually, I think you can just add the square element and then type text in here. This is just how I'm used to creating these button effects, whatever. All right, change the button color, and you can preview this. Now, do you want to make sure that you keep this for the static video? I like to keep it under 15 seconds. That way it gets like one of the placements is like the Facebook Reels. Because if the video is too long, it won't show up in certain placements. Obviously, we want to make sure we're in as many placements as possible. So you could preview this, and there you go. That's literally all you have to do. And I think there's different effects on here, animations for the text. I actually think it's really cool. But if you don't want that, you can just click on animate where it says pan here. These are all the different animations, and you can change it to whatever animation you want. I think they're really cool and very effective for these types of ads, for these static video ads. So definitely play around with that. You could also add music to it as well. So if we go to this is one, I think they moved it to elements. Music. There we go. So yeah, audio right here. So you can even add music and audio to this if you want. So play around with that. That's your static video, guys. All you do is click. So give it a name, share, download this. You're going to download as an MP4, put it into your ads manager. That's it. It's literally all you have to do. Really cool looking ad. All right. And then last one, we'll do the carousel ad here. And for some reason, I just can't find this template. So you know what? Because I was doing a search on the homepage earlier for this specific template for carousel ads because it works so good, and I wanted to share it with you guys. So here, let's see. I will link this specific type of template down below if you guys want to use this one. But to be honest, there's so many good carousel ad templates already in here. So if we go back to the homepage and we just type in carousel, it's starting to get a little dark there. That dark. There we go. All right. Make sure you're on templates. And like I've used so many of these. I wouldn't say one is really better than another. It really comes down to just keeping it simple, in my opinion. Just find one that's easy to customize. It's in alignment with your brand, things like that. If we hover over it, you can get a preview of the carousel ad here. Like I've used this one before. This works really good. I've used one like this. But test out a couple of different templates and see which one works best, you know, split test them. But the main thing is just being able to get more content into the ad creative. That's all we're doing. So when we find a template that we like, all we're going to do is select it. We're going to customize this template. Okay. And at this point, guys, literally all you're going to do is come in and edit the text here. And you know, we can delete some of it as well, you know, stuff that we don't need. You do want to be careful with arrows. I think arrows are okay, but you don't want, I think there's a couple of examples here, in the carousel ad where it said, yeah, see it like on this one where it says swipe, you want to delete that, because I have had ads rejected for that purpose. Facebook doesn't like for some reason, instructions to swipe a certain direction. At least, maybe that's changed. I don't know. You could test it, but that's just been my experience. So keep that in mind. But we're just going to scroll down here and change. You know, you're just customizing the template here, guys. That's literally all you're doing. You can put your buttons in here if you want, and you're just coming in and writing out like a longer version of the ad creative. You're kind of almost putting some of your ad copy into the carousel ad. So again, in this example, we're getting attention by, you know, we're targeting business owners, obviously, ready to reduce your annual FICA payroll tax, okay? While also increasing employee recruitment and retention at the same time. All right, new section 125 pre-tax plan. So I'm going into a lot more detail about what this lead magnet is going to do, what this program is going to do, the problem that it's going to solve, how it works, et cetera. That's all I'm doing with this carousel ad. And, you know, I added, like, you can add little elements here if you want. So I'll show you how to do that. If we go to elements and then let's see, we were talking about taxes there. So let's type in taxes, right? We're on elements, typed in taxes here. We're going to click on graphics and let's say, you know, I like this guy right here. So I'm going to add that. And it just, again, it just makes everything more engaging and, you know, just more visually appealing sometimes. Obviously you don't want to overdo it, but adding these little things sometimes can make a pretty big difference, right? So that's really the only difference between this template and this one right here is the element there. But other than that, we're literally just going through our ads, the different slides here and customizing the text. That's it. And if you need to add a page, then all you do is click add page here. You can also duplicate the page as well. So if you've made some specific changes that you want to pass on to the next page here, we're just going to clone this page and then you just change the text a little bit. That's it. And you do that until you have enough pages within your carousel ad. I try to keep my carousel ad at most eight pages. I have gone over before and they've worked okay, but you want to try to keep it under 8 pages if possible. Like you don't want it to be so long, like, you know, people getting annoyed, like, okay, come on, get to the point here. Like you should be just providing bite-sized information inside of these types of ads. And then giving that call to action at the end, click the learn more button down below to request your free ebook, masterclass, guide, whatever it is. Okay. So I think that's it. This was just another carousel ad. Actually, I think it showed up. Where was it? I thought I saw it earlier. I know I saw it earlier, but anyways, again, this one was, so we're done with that. All right. This one was, I literally typed in carousel, found this, it was easy to customize. And this is the one that I'm going to be testing soon. Right. So it's literally the same thing as this one. It's just a different design. That's it. So anyways, I'll go ahead and wrap up there, guys. I hope that was helpful. Gives you a few different types of ad creatives that you can quickly make inside of Canva, just using their templates and customizing them. Like you could make all of the ad creatives for your campaign within an hour, I would say. Like if you're brand new to Canva, then maybe it'll take you a little bit to get used to it. It's not hard to use. But otherwise, I mean, all you're doing is customizing a template. So I hope that was helpful, guys. If you have any questions, drop some comments down below. Let me know what you think about this. If there's anything specific that you want me to make a video on with regards to marketing, Facebook ads, Canva, I don't care what it is, high level, then drop them down in the comment section. But I hope you guys are crushing it. And I will talk to you in the next one. To your success, Matty Ice is out.